Hey, Jody here. Today we're TIG welding on some 18 gauge cold rolled steel lap joints. Let's do it.
So we'll be going over some tips and techniques for flash tacking, the different amperages and settings for tacking as opposed to welding, using some big chunks of aluminum for a weight as well as some heat sink, some tips and techniques for the weld out, and of course some good instructive arc shots. So the first one we're going to do is tack with a number 5 regular ceramic cup with only about 10 CFH of argon. That not only saves gas, but it also helps get a nice crisp arc start. If you got a big blast of pressure on your arc start, a lot of times your arc start will be erratic. And what I'm going for here is really small, clean tack. So I'm just gonna blast it with a really quick burst of 80 amps. That's a lot of amps for 18 gauge steel, but I'm gonna be on and off the pedal so quickly that all it's gonna do is put a nice clean tack on there that barely nips the corner. And when I go back over that with the weld, I should be able to completely consume that where you can't really tell where the tacks are. You could use a screwdriver to hold it down. I'm using a copper spoon I got from Harbor Freight. I have also made, you know, DIY tools, just building up the tip of an old trappy screwdriver with silicon bronze and then shaping it however I want to for doing this operation. It helps to hold it sometimes right next to where you're going to weld. You can not only put a lot of pressure on it. When you can't get a clamp on something, you can put a lot of pressure on it to get rid of the gap, and you don't want any gap in a thin lap weld at all. So I've got a tack about every inch or so there. It's time to switch over to a bigger cup now for the weld out. I'm using a clear 8 cup here. I'll show you a little bit more about that at the end of this video. I got to crank my argon up to 20 CFH now for the 8 cup. Something else that's going to help a lot is using these big blocks of aluminum, not only as a weight to keep it from wobbling. Sometimes when you light up on something, the electricity goes through it, it starts wobbling and chattering and everything. But not only is it a weight, but it's a heat sink, and it traps a little bit of argon, and it helps a lot. I know I've said this multiple times, but I'm going to say it again. I started using clear cups just to help film so we could all see the arc and where I'm going and where I've been a lot better. But I noticed they help me to see where I'm going a lot better as well. They just kind of light things up like a floodlight bulb ahead of where I'm going. I can use all the help I can get these days. The thinner something is, the more backstep technique that I use, and that's what I'm doing today here. I'm backstepping a little bit. I'm welding half of this run first and then backing up and welding to the start of that previous bead. I don't want to go too far. This is kind of rigid because it's a cube, but on certain things, the farther you weld, the more they'll distort, and making nice short runs and backstepping your welds on sheet metal, it helps a lot in avoiding distortion. In fact, when I was making this cube in a prior video, I used these big aluminum blocks for the outside corner joints to pull heat out, and they worked great. And I'll try to link that up about right here. Well, let's keep going with this thing. Up in just a second, we're going to talk a little bit about machine settings and kind of how to determine what amperage you need for a sheet metal lap joint like this. One way to figure it out is try to figure out the minimum amperage it takes to run a fusion pass without filler metal, and then just add about 5% more amps when you add filler. Now, I'm only using 045 filler here, so I only need just a few more amps as opposed to what it would take for just doing a fusion weld. But here are the basic settings for the flash tacking as well as the weld out. One of the biggest mistakes you can make on a lap joint on thin metal like this is too long of an arc. That's probably the biggest one. It needs a tight arc. So what is a tight arc? Well, in my opinion, it's the diameter of the electrode or less. Now, if you get too tight, you'll start sputtering and you'll be cleaning electrodes all day long. But I'm using a 3/32 diameter electrode here. I'm striving for about a 1/16 arc length. Another thing is torch angle. You don't need that much. Fortunately, torch angle is pretty forgiving, especially if you're holding a good tight arc. A lot of times you think you've got about a 10 or 15 degree torch angle and you've got more like a 25 or 30. Like looking at this right here, I'm probably at least 25, but it's working out just fine due to the tight arc. An obvious tip is to make sure to have a clean, sharp electrode. I'm saying it anyway because it's really important. If you sputter and get a little fuzz on the tip of your electrode on a joint like this on pretty thin metal on a lap joint, you're just not going to be able to direct that arc like you want to. So keeping a nice, sharp, clean tip, super important. This is about how I prep them for a job like this. Let's take a look at the filler rod hand now for this little run. I'm choked up pretty tight on it because it's 045 filler. The smaller the filler, the tighter you have to choke up from the tip to where your hand is, otherwise it'll flop around too much. And I'm dabbing rod about once every 16th of an inch or so. Now if this were thick aluminum, I'd be probably stepping out almost an eighth of an inch, but it's not. It's thin steel. If I try to step out too far, the edge is liable to curl away. So it's good. It works for me to keep the rod dabbed in there fairly often. Now this is the last run here, and there's really nothing new to show, so I'm just going to speed things up here so we can see the finished product. Lap joints are used a lot for repairs, like doubler repairs on grit blast cabinets or even in aviation. So this cup did a great job. Here's a few other clips of previous videos. Here's one I was welding a cube on aluminum using the same 8 clear cup. It's a good all-around cup for both steel and aluminum. Sometimes it's a real big help to be able to see through the cup, to be able to see exactly where your tungsten and your wire is. But the real benefit for me is it just lights things up and helps me see better. If you think it might help you, if you're having a little trouble seeing where you're going, go to weldmonger.com, check it out if it makes sense for you. You can read some of the reviews. And they've put together some little packages here, some little small convenient kits that have a ceramic as well as a clear cup for each torch. Whether you got a 17, 18, 26 or a 920 style, there's a kit just for your torch along with some visual aids to tell what kind of torch you have. So if this makes sense for you, check it out at weldmonger.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.